Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over two different functions that we can use together. And these two functions are the COUNTIF function and the OR logical function.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I have a spreadsheet. And what I would like to do to show you the OR function is I would first like to click on this cell and I would like to evaluate whether or not the district is one of these three options. So if I type equals and I type the word OR with a left parenthesis, I will be prompted for my first logical evaluation. And so I want my first logical evaluation to be what I have over here in B2, if that's equal to what I have over here in F1. And then I'm going to type a comma. So in regular English, I have just said the district in B2 is equal to Wellington. Or let's select B2 again, equals what I have over here in F2, which is Waterloo. And then I'm going to type a comma again. And then my third OR is the value that I have in B2 is equal to what I have in F3, which is Westwood. And I'm going to close my parentheses. But before I hit enter, I want you to think about this for a second. Is Dundas, Wellington, or Waterloo, or Westwood? The answer is no. So I should be returned with a false. And I am. However, if I go to D3 and I type equals OR with a left parenthesis, and this time I use B3 equals Wellington, comma, or B3 equals Waterloo, comma, or B3 equals Westwood in a parenthesis. So again, think about this. Is what is in B3 equal to one of these? And the answer is yes, it is equal to one of those. So I should be returned with a true, and I am. However, before I can copy the formula, let's go back into here. And you can see that F1, F2, and F3 is going to move if I copy this formula. However, I want these cells to stay static because that's where I've put my values. So if I click in front of F1 and I hit function F4, you can see that my dollar signs were automatically put in, and that means an absolute reference to this cell, no matter where I copy the formula. So I want to do that for each one of my Fs. Again, that's function F4, and then function F4 one more time. And then I'm going to hit enter. And then if I double-click on this bottom right-hand square in this cell, my formula will be copied to the bottom of my data set. Now what I want to show you is if I highlight all of these and look on my status bar down here, I can see that I have a count of 24.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So theoretically, what I could do is I could just count how many of these are true. And then I would know how many of my people are in these three districts. So in here, I could just do equals count if left parenthesis, my range is right here. I could type a comma, and then for my criteria, I could do double quotes and type in true, do a right parenthesis and hit enter. And I can see that I get 14. So I am using count if, and I'm using OR over here. So let's delete the formula that we have in here and just type equals count if in a left parenthesis. So what I want to do is count anything in column B and then type a comma. And then if that value is equal to what's in F1 and close my parenthesis. So now I'm using a count if for all the Wellington. And if I hit enter, I can see that I'm getting 5. However, in my count if, I can do addition on this function. So if I click here and I type plus and I do count if again with a left parenthesis, select the same range, type a comma, and this time I'm going to hit F2 and a right parenthesis. And if I hit enter, now I'm getting 9. But this is not accounting for Westwood. That's why I'm not quite at 14 yet. So if I click back in here and I do plus count if one more time with a left parenthesis, I want to do column B, type a comma, and this time I want to pick up Westwood and hit the right parenthesis and hit enter. I can now see that I am getting 14, which is the same number of trues that I have in here. So if that was too many count ifs for you, what if I just did one count if? What if I did equals count if with a left parenthesis, and I picked this range, and I typed a comma, and then what if I selected all three of these as my criteria and that parenthesis? What would happen? Well, if I hit enter, I get what's known as a spillover. So the 5 is going to be associated with Wellington, the 4 with Waterloo, and the 5 with Westwood. So what if I didn't want this to spill over? How could I get around that? What I would like to do is sum up this 5 plus this 4 plus this 5. And I can accomplish that with a simple sum function. So if I go up here and I type sum with the left parenthesis, and at the end of my count if spilling function, if I type another parenthesis and I hit enter, I will be returned with the 14 and it will no longer be spilling over. So you can see that if I use sum for the spilling over count if, I will get the entire sum of what I've been looking for. We do have another way to do this using the sum product function out on our blog. I will include the link to our blog in the description below on YouTube if you would like to visit there and see another way you could do this. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.